What's up, y'all?
Doubt.
We back.
Doubt.
It's Fridays.
AT here, lock with me.
Best day of the week. Y'all ain't peeped it already, check the Monday mix. Check the intro video and check the story time video so you get caught up on everything we're talking about this week.
Doubt.
Exactly. It's focused on doubt in the days. So, how you feeling today, man?
I'm all right. It's another day in the days, as we like to say.
Yeah.
But we got to keep it moving.
Keep it moving, man.
What you been listening to this week?
Man,
I've been overcome.
I've been bumping on some real. I've been bumping some crazy hype stuff. I've been bumping a lot of hype stuff, man. I've got a lot of future.
That new week. Energy.
Yeah, just trying to keep it moving. Just trying to find that motivation. You know what I'm saying?
The new energy is in the mix, of course.
Exactly, dog. We got the one go. We got the WizKid in there, man.
Post Malone. Exactly. We got 21. We got everybody you bumping.
We got the heat in there, so definitely go peep that. With that being said, though, we're going to go ahead and get jump right into the topic.
Yes, sir.
And like I said earlier, that is doubt in the days. So we're going to talk about how doubt can be caused, you know? And I feel like, if anything, doubt can be caused by the outside influences, you know?
Strong part.
Exactly. And with the, like we said earlier, though, this is, you know, it's a relative situation, so it can be used in for good. You know, you can use it as a way to use it to your advantage and find a way to catch that spark and move forward.
And as we said in the intro as well, it definitely plays a part on your experiences in life itself. So these experiences that you go through change your perspective.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, if you get, you're playing a game, as we use the athlete example again,
right.
Playing a game and something happens, everybody's booing you, of course you're gonna doubt yourself.
Mm-hmm.
That's why it's like these people out in the league.
Yeah.
You gotta give them a lot of credit.
It is what it is.
With all their face and, you know what I mean, all the media speculation, all that type of BS going on, to still be able to go out and try to play.
Yeah.
That's not easy.
And that's a lot of doubt. That's a lot of doubt. And even get to the point where you're in the NBA, to get through the point where you get cut from the team, or you make the team, or you get crossed up in middle school. You get crossed up and you get your ankles took in college or something like that. You know, you get dunked on in the tryouts or something like that.
The MJ example, exactly. What they always say, that he got cut from his JV team or whatnot.
Exactly. And it was in the gym. Like, man, I'm better. I'm about to prove it. And it's a matter, that's how you took doubt. Some people took that way a different way. Like, maybe I'm not supposed to play basketball.
True.
Some people took it a different way and they just took it to the extreme. And I'm gonna say OJ. But in MJ's position, he took it to the extreme and became the best in the sport. So
that's what it's about. And obviously it's not just athletes, people in
daily
grind as well. You could be at work and your boss questioning your worth ethic or something related to that, your numbers, your figures, whatever it be.
Yeah.
And you start questioning your own ability. Yeah. Can I actually perform?
You see, it's a lot in the industry as well. We're gonna talk to people later, man. I'm gonna bring them up right now. G-Eazy and Uzi and stuff like that. Just a lot of mixed reviews coming their way.
Right.
You know, G-Eazy with in different album sales and in different record results and stuff like that. So he has a different type of doubt to get through with him being also a white rapper. That's a whole different situation in the culture. And recently I saw him talking, shouting out Eminem about the Kaepernick thing. And I don't know if that's a good look or not. So I'm gonna have to let that
result. There's a lot going on with that.
Yeah, I'm gonna let that just do his thing. But also with Uzi, you know, it's a lot of, he comes at it with a different approach, and a lot of people give him a lot of mixed reviews about it. And he had to move through that doubt to try and.
Everybody's a critic nowadays, especially with social media. There's a lot of energy, as I said earlier, that comes. You know what I mean, critics.
Yeah, but constant access to information.
Exactly, and people always seeing your stuff. Maybe they want to comment on it.
Yeah.
Maybe negative, positive, whatever it be, type of comments. They're gonna affect you. If you see them, you know what I mean?
Yeah, so, that's your days, you know what I mean? And I thought about that too. Like, some people, they just go straight off the grid. They just like don't even access that stuff. And that's taking control of the days. Like, I don't want any of that to affect me.
None of that energy my way.
None of that doubt will affect you if you're not interacting with it.
You see the news and you start questioning where you stand.
Yeah.
There's plenty of things that cause that doubt that are external, but of course there is also that self-doubt that comes from inside.
Exactly. So, and that's what I talked about earlier, taking advantage of that. And those new information, that new perspective being brought to you, like, oh, maybe I'm not that great. You know, explore that possibility and find out how you can be great.
Yeah.
You know, if you don't feel like you're great, great is a relative term. So, I mean, if you don't feel like you're great, some people might not, but if you don't feel like you're great, then that's what matters. And you gotta move
keep
and
make moving. Moves.
to try and get to that point where you consider yourself great.
Of course, that's what it's always about.
So what can actually, you know, we're gonna get jump right into it right now. Like what can actually cause like doubt in the days though? You know, like give some examples. Like
we said, those external critics, you know what I mean? Comments, whatever it be. External factors like not performing on certain things like tests. Mm. Things that are standardized and, you know what I mean? People, you in order to pass school, you have to take this test.
Yeah, true.
If everybody else is passing, what are you gonna look like if you fail? You know, stuff like that. So it's always those external factors. Again, we also said the internal stuff does play a part as well.
True.
And that self-doubt.
And I feel like some of the internal stuff comes from, you know, just going through time and, you know, just progressing through time, but not necessarily seeing any type of real results or large results or not the expected results. And I feel like that type of stuff can bring doubt into the conversation.
Yeah.
But it's like I said, it's a conversation starter. It starts making you consider different ways to go about executing the same issue. And if anything, it helps you find a more efficient way to go about it to actually get closer to accomplishing that goal.
True. And that doubt, I heard something throughout the week or over the week, and it was on the Gary Vee vlog, basically saying where this doubt is basically you expect to be at a certain place.
Mm-hmm.
And nobody really, you don't deserve any, nobody really deserves anything. You know what I mean? That's part of the days itself as well, where nobody, you got to get it. You know what I mean? You got to want to get it and can't really kind of look to be at a certain place that you should be.
Mm-hmm.
Because at the end of the day, you gotta put in the time and that work. And then, you know what I mean? We talked about Cardi B last week and some of her success. Yeah. And at the end of the day, her work ethic proved
to
win out, you know what I mean?
I feel like even in this case today, the people we're talking about today's today's retwist, man, it's like same type of situation with Uzi, just grinding, man. It's just about matter of grinding. Faced with doubt, had every reason to stop, you know, every reason to just go a different route, figure something out, but, you know, dude just didn't stop, so, and that's where he is right now, going through the doubt, because it ain't like he wasn't doubted, you know, that's a one thing you can definitely count on, so.
And of course, we're talking about that self-doubt as well,
mm-hmm.
and through the days, obviously, we see all these walls being placed in front of yourself, almost like you're putting these walls in front of yourself.
And in your mind, that is, they're almost impossible.
Yeah, you can't move past them, can't move through them, whatever it be.
It's just distortion, man. At the end of the day, like, everything, you can move past anything.
Yeah.
But it's just the days, man.
You gotta be creative and figure out a way, almost. And that's part of the days that we always talk about. This distortion limits what you actually can see. Is there another way? Is there a way through that I can't see? Is there a small crack? Whatever it be.
Yeah.
And it's always about looking to kind of find where you can move past this doubt and get through the wall and get on to the next step, whether it be another wall or whatever it be.
Exactly. I feel like the wall, even though it may be a metaphorical wall that may or may not be a figment of your imagination in a metaphorical sense, the fact that you feel is there, the fact that you see is there, that doubt that's being brought upon by that is a red flag on your end, because it's like, okay, you're not fully invested in what you're doing. You're not fully confident in the plan, at least in the plot that you plotted up. You don't feel like it's actually gonna get the job done. So that alone makes you sure that you need to go back and reevaluate and replan your steps and then move forward with a new set of plans, you know what I mean?
And that's important because it's gonna alter what is reality and what you see as reality.
It changes the entire vision, man.
It's gonna make you question everything. That's exactly what doubt does, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It makes you question your abilities, what is real. It
makes you question someone else's abilities.
Exactly.
You know, it makes you question everything. I feel like that question alone is motivation, but I mean, it's to a certain extent. It's how you take it. You know, some people take it to a sense where it's like discouragement. Some people take it as a sense like, oh, it's a challenge, you know, so.
Another day in the days, right?
Yeah, man.
Just trying to conquer. This is the topic. Check out the intro, the Monday mix, all of the retwist, all
of
the week's
vibes,
content.
Man. Bunch of new vibes coming for y'all this week. And again, that's every Friday. Check the links in the descriptions for all that content. And until next week, we out.